Hi, Dynabomb. It's Paul and Kristen here. For Christmas, we just want to say that Jesus is the reason for the season. And that's always in your newsletters, usually. We miss you. And,
we do.
We want to read some scripture to you so you can, you know, grab a coffee or whatever your favorite drink is and sit by the fire, because we know in Florida you have a fireside, right? And we're going to read some scripture to you from Matthew 5 and 6 for your listening pleasure and just to get the word of God inside of your hearts. So we're going to start. Chapter 5. Now, when he saw the crowds, he went up on a mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. I tell you the truth, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least stroke of a pen will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. Anyone who breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever practices and teaches these commands will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you that unless your righteousness surpasses that of the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, you will certainly not enter the kingdom of heaven." So that is the portion of chapter 5.
I just wanted to mention one thing to you, mom and dad, that they're the words of a Bible study, a Bible teacher that we love. Her name is Jen Wilkin. And when Paul was reading the Beatitudes, I couldn't help but think of you guys and your long legacy of just multiplying the word of God, multiplying the hearing of the word of God. And she said, people who love the Lord have a greater responsibility to heal fractured relationships as far as they are able. Why? Blessed are the peacemakers. We are the ones who know what it means to be reconciled to a holy God who we offended. We have found acceptance with God. So we of all people should pursue reconciliation in our human relationships. And I really believe that your lives represent that message, that you are true peacemakers. You have spent your lives healing fractured relationships in other people's lives, helping them figure out how to do that very thing. And it's because you have realized in your life what you have been forgiven from, and you have multiplied the hearing and the acting upon that message. And we just want you to know that that legacy continues in our family, and that we love you so much.
Love you, Dad and Mom. Goodbye.